Hello everybody, let's continue exploring hands-on education. So today we are going to discuss about props. Props or property are widely used in theater plays. The common factor between a theater play and education is engagement. If you can engage, we have success from the audience or the students here. So to explore this, let's first understand three types of props. Type one of the prop is hand prop. A hand prop is mobile. For example, a teacher takes the leaves to explain the venation type to the classroom. The students experience the leaves, touch the leaves, observe the venation. So whenever he goes outside, he sees a leaf, his imagination gets ignited, saying that, oh, what kind of venation this leaf has. So that's the power of the prop. Number two prop is personal prop. A teacher wears different types of fabric and explains that this is a cotton cap, silk dress and any other fabric. So that way explaining different fabrics is very easy for the child. That is, personal props are wearing something and going to the classroom. Number three is set prop, which is fixed. Probably a chart paper is fixed on the wall. Everybody's attention is driven to the wall. So this is called a set prop or a disorientation of the furniture in a such a way that the engagement improves. So this is also a prop, a disorientation. So like this, we understand that there are three types of props. One is hand prop, second one is personal prop, third one is set prop. So these are the three type of props can be applied in the classroom, and this is very closer to the hands-on education. Now let's understand top three advantages of using props in the classroom. Number one advantage is ignite the imagination. The imagination of the child gets ignited once he sees and learns like that. So he sees and learns the different types of venation. So when he goes out in the world, any leaf is teaching him. So that's the power of igniting the imagination. Number two is attract and retain. That is when in normal class without a prop, if the attraction is 50 to 60%, here the chances goes up to 90% because of the prop. That's the power of using the prop. Number three is it will allow to be closer to reality. So when we use the props, the reality comes very closer to the child's understanding. So that's the power of using a prop. These are the top three advantages of the props. Now I'll share an example. What I did in 2004 when I have to teach MS Office in the classroom, I took a typewriter to the classroom. The children are asked to type and asked what are the disadvantages. So children typed and got engaged by typing a paper, and they all together came and wrote the disadvantages of a typewriter. Then I made them find out a solution in the MS Word for all the disadvantages. So this prop called typewriter made them feel why the innovation called MS Word happened and why they need to learn. So this has got a deeper impact. I have observed that this classroom was so profound for the students and to me as a teacher. I'm going to share one more example. My professor Chandwani, who is master in using the props in my marketing class to teach niche marketing, that day he bought all the products of Johnson & Johnson. So he made us touch, feel and made us understand this is the beautiful example of niche marketing. Even today, after closer to 18 years, I remember it so fresh. He was a master in using props to teach the students. Thank you, Sanjay Chandwani sir, for being that. So this is about props. Props have got deeper impact on the students' learning. So I would recommend to use props, and let's keep exploring together on hands-on education. Signing off today, Active Vamshi.